stand for some DIY. Why? Because I love it.
What's up, guys? Welcome to Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob, and it's time for some DIY. Now, Holi is coming up, and I love Holi because Holi is the festival of colors. And I love colors, but I don't love colors on me. That's right. I love dry colors, they are fine, but the wet ones, not at all. Because sometimes it takes days, sometimes weeks to get it off from your body, which I don't like at all. And if you are like me, who loves Holi and loves colors, but not on the body, then you are in the perfect place because today we are going to do a DIY just with colors. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. So today I have planned a really simple and super fun DIY for you guys. We are doing bubble art today. I'm sure many of you must have tried this when you were younger, and if you haven't, then you really must. It's such a fun technique. Let's start. I have a bowl here. Now in this bowl, I'm going to put some acrylic colors. So I'm taking some acrylic color here. Now we'll add some water to this. Now we'll mix it well. Okay, so our color is ready. Now we have to add our ingredient that will help us make some bubbles. And for that, I'm using some liquid detergent soap or some dishwashing soap. So let's add that. Okay, now we will mix it again. All right, we are done. Okay, before we start making some bubbles, I need to put a cardboard sheet because when the bubbles burst, they tend to spill a little bit. And I don't want to make my table dirty. All right, this is ready. Let's get a straw in and time to make some bubbles. And once you have enough bubbles like this, you can quickly take a sheet and gently dab it before the bubbles burst. And there you go. You can see we have a nice bubble print on our paper. So let's try a few more in different places. Okay, let's try another color. As you can see, we have lots of different prints here in different colors. Now you can just pick and choose and see what you want to do with it. So here I have two bubble art prints that I've decided to work on. So first we'll start with the orange one. So here I have some black acrylic color and some water. Now we are going to do some Chinese brush style painting here. Now I am no expert at Chinese brush style painting, but I have developed a style over the years, so I'm going to show you what I do. So what I'm doing now is I'm dipping the brush in the acrylic color and then I'm washing it off with water so that I have very little color on my brush, and I will now just make a triangular shape here. So you can see it's like almost like a washed out effect. Once you have your basic form like I've done here, now I'll take some more color, and this time I will not dilute it so that the color is darker and more opaque. And now I'm going to add details to it just like this in single strokes. Now after these couple of strokes, I'm sure you can see that I am making a bird. That's why I started with this triangular shape, which is almost like a flying bird. And there you go. I have a very minimalistic single stroke washed out bird here. So let's try another one. For this other one, I am drawing the head first. And then again, I'm washing off the color to give a washed out effect for the body. And then again, I'm picking acrylic color, which is darker. And then I'm putting this on this washed ink-like effect. And similarly, I'm going to add a few more birds to both of the prints. Okay, I'm done with the birds, so let's add some more details. I think these bubble shapes are looking like giant trees, so I'm going to add branches to it following the same technique. So you can see I'm not taking the acrylic color directly, I'm giving it a very washed kind of effect because most of the Chinese paintings are like that. And then with the darker one, you can add a little bit of detail. Looks like we are done. There you go. Let's get the colors out. And you can see both the prints are ready. I think they look pretty cool. So we had a very simple bubble print or pattern on it. And like I said, we used to do this when we were younger or when we were kids. But with these birds, they look like a cool print, probably like an expensive painting or a Chinese masterpiece. So I have made birds here, but if you want, you can try different characters or creatures. I have done just two colors, like orange on one and blue on one, but you can try a whole range of colors, try multicolor prints, overlap prints and see what you get, because the results are fantastic, they look great, and you can take prints on anything, on any surface. Like you can take it on paper or you can take it on ceramic, like mugs, make envelopes or lamps out of these paper and prints. Just be creative and explore. So what did you think of this bubble art printing technique? I think it's super fun. I absolutely love it because it's so simple and the results are fantastic. This was also done with bubble art technique. Pretty cool, right? I used to love this technique as a kid and I still absolutely love it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, then please give it a big thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe to my channel. It's free. Please do it so that you are updated with all this cool stuff that happens in this space. Also, if you don't want to step outdoors and play Holi like me, then you can still stay indoors and have a colorful Holi by trying this colorful technique of bubble art printing. So please play with colors. I'm not stopping you from playing with colors. Do it in your own style. Be creative, just like me. And if you're trying it, then please click pictures and share them with me. You know how to get in touch with me. I'm on Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, and right here in this DIY space, making fun videos just for you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, do good and be good. Peace. And happy Holi, guys. Have a colorful and safe Holi. I'll see you soon.